Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, welcome to my channel. This channel is The Novel Nana, and my name is Bex. So today, in this video, we will be discussing grief and how to write grief for your characters. So if that's something of interest to you, and maybe you are writing a story that deals with any particular loss for your character, you might want to stay tuned. I might have some things that you haven't quite thought of yet. So anyway, let's get right into the video. And if this is a topic that you would like to discuss further, leave me a comment. Also, subscribe to the channel if you would like to. And if you do like this kind of content, just give it a thumbs up. It helps me and the algorithm. Okay, so let's get into the video. Most of you know about grief. Many of us, I'm assuming all of us, have experienced loss in some way, fashion, or form along in our lifetime. However, when writing grief, there are some things that you might want to consider putting into your novel because, or your work in progress, whatever it may be, short story, novella, whatever. But when writing, there are certain things that you want to draw the reader in and help them find that relatability or that connective tissue to really pull at their heartstrings or give them that gut punch moment. Now, I understand that grief is a very sensitive subject, but I'm talking about grief in writing. So, let me see if I can explain this in a way that you will be able to understand and both draw some sort of value from the content and apply it to your writing. So most of us know the seven stages of grief. I'm not going to go, you know, too in depth with everything that I have written down. These are just some points that I would like to make, and it helps me keep on topic when I have something to guide me and kind of push me forward. You guys know me. I love to talk. That's me. So anyway, for this video, I'm going to try to condense it and give you a few examples of how this might manifest for your character and in writing your character and their grief. So the seven stages of grief, in some way, fashion, or form, are basically these things that I've written down. So denial and shock. This is the stage of grief where you have disbelief, numbness, and like this isn't happening or this can't be for real. That's that kind of moment, that stage in grief. Then there's pain and guilt, which is that unbearable feeling and your needs. And it's where you sometimes compartmentalize and analyze the situation. As it were, of death. Anger and bargaining is the next. This is where we often lash out, and you often ask, how could this have happened, or why? Then we move on to depression, which is usually that isolation and loneliness stage. This is also where you process and reflect upon that loss, sort of like, I will never get past that, that kind of moment. Then we go on to the upward turn, and this is where your anger and your pain have subsided a bit or have died down, and this is a more relaxed state of feeling or being, and this is also where you know that you can go on. Then we move on to the reconstruction or working through that coping stage. This is where you carry on moving forward and putting your life's pieces back together, basically. And you also kind of pull from that, like, what can I learn from this situation? It's a way of coping. Now we move on to the acceptance and hope. This is where you are working around that pain and that loss. It's also accepting the future possibilities or how that future might look now with that loss in place. And it's where you accept the future possibility and hope and implement some sort of lesson into your own life. Now, okay, this to me is, and I'm sure as for a lot of you, we have all experienced loss in our lifetime, whether that mean a family member or a friend or a beloved pet. We have all went through, most of us have anyway, these stages. Now, for my purpose of this video, I wanted to really reach out to other writers because I have read books and kind of think back to the books that you have read. I personally have read books where a character that we have followed along in their journey, we have seen the closeness of their relationship, or maybe we've just been told about a relationship, and we are to believe that they have this bond or this closeness, this sentimental attachment, and then somewhere along in the story, this person is killed off, you know, how us writers love to kill our little darlings, but this person is killed off in some way, fashion, or form, and the main character just moves on. They just accept it right away. This I do not like in writing. It is not realistic, and I feel like it doesn't connect with the readers. So if you do have that moment where you're killing off your darlings, just remember to let that loss be shown. We don't always need to be told that they were feeling sad or despondent or whatever, but let the reader be shown how it has affected your main character and their life and their decisions and whatever process of, you know, stages of grief that they may be in. You know, give us a glimpse. This will help the reader feel more connected. It provides that vulnerability, that little look inside of their lives, that helps the relatability factor, okay? So keep that in mind. Also, remember how the symptoms of grief might manifest in different ways or different areas of your main character's life. So emotionally, physically, socially, and also, you know, towards that religious nature. Whatever the case may be, however it is shown in your work, in your writing, for your main character. Also think about their habits. Has anything changed within their habits? Maybe their eating or their sleeping habits or even their social activities. Now, I'm not saying that you have to draw out the process, you know, to some ridiculous length. We don't have to be just, you know, head first into their grief, but it is nice to see that realistic nature of human beings. It's nice to see it come out in writing. So I don't know about you, but like I said, I've read books where we are told how the main character feels about, you know, XYZ person in their life. And when that loss happens, a lot of times in books, I have seen where they just skip right over it. They, you know, immediately move in to acceptance. And maybe they go off on, you know, a quest or some sort of revenge plot, whatever the case may be. But we don't really see it affecting the character. And that is not relatable. It is not realistic. So in writing, just consider these things, how it might affect your main character and their journey. Also, think about the age or the manner of death in which the person that they lost, how long have they known them? What is the intimacy level between them? Are they best friends? Are they, you know, childhood sweethearts? Are they nemesis? You know, whatever the case may be, how would it affect your main character and their decision-making process? How would it affect their daily lives? How would it affect the goal that they are trying to reach? Would it cause any stumbling blocks, any triggering mechanisms to occur? So anyway, moving on, let's talk about how it can also manifest. How does it affect the character, their motivation? And as I said, you know, show, don't tell us this. Give us just a little glimpse of that vulnerable side of them. Let's see, for triggers, think about the activities or whatever commonality, whatever common thread they might have had with the person that they have lost in the story. How might that manifest in or along their journey? Is there some place that they might go through or walk past or visit that might bring on that emotion? Can you show us how it affects them? Do they have a heartwarming feeling when they walk through the gardens where they used to meet, or, you know, if it's that type of relationship, how does it feel to be in that space, you know, occupying that space without that significant other or whatever the case may be? Is there a place or a song or an activity that you can hint at in your story that can bring us back to that full circle moment? Is there a way that you can interject those same feelings of that loss or that intimacy level that they had with that other character? This will make your character more realistic, more relatable. So show us that twinge of sadness. Show us that heartwarming effect, you know, to be remembered fondly. Just show us something to help us be more immersed in your character. Also, let's go on to the, we've done the coping skills. What are their coping skills? What are the mechanisms that they use to get them through that devastation moment? Also, what about their fears? How would that loss play upon their fears? How would that I don't even know the word I'm looking for here, guys. Give me a minute. It'll come back around. It always does. Their views on life or on mortality. Do those things shift? Do those things change? Are those things now, you know, under some sort of veil or some sort of screen for them? Do they view life the same? Also, any change or adaptations to their behavior, or maybe how they go about, you know, trying to find a cure for this not to happen again. Or maybe in your situation, maybe they are going after a person who maybe took that person's life. Maybe it's like a revenge plot or some sort of redemption. Can you use any of this to show the reader or bring them along for that ride, basically showing us that gut-wrenching moment for them and the payoff, that satisfactory moment when they have redeemed themselves or made amends somehow through that grief or through that character connection of that loss? Do they bond with others? Do they cement friendships? Do they have a common bond because of the loss? Is it a loss to the group? Is it a loss only to your main character? How might it affect the plot or them reaching the end goal? Does it change anything for them? Was this person that they lost a key person in attaining that goal? Just things to think about. Moving on to memorializing, honor, or paying tribute. So is there a spot in your novel or your book, whatever it is that you're working on, is there a spot that you can give us a callback? Maybe, you know, your character has traveled a long time on their journey, and maybe along the way, they have been working through the stages of grief. Maybe they come to a point where they can memorialize somehow, or maybe they can honor or pay tribute to that one that they have lost. That feels not only a bit of closure for the reader and for your MC, but also, you know, could do a physical or emotional reminder of how that relationship worked or how that relationship ended or even how it began. You could do a full circle moment and it'll have a greater payoff. Okay, so moving on, I did want to mention that not only, you know, there are 7 stages of grief, however, we don't always do them in order. A lot of people say that, you know, you can repeat a certain stage. I personally disagree with that. I believe that there is a moment where you you don't actually repeat that phase of grief, but you expose the pause in the process. So it's like you didn't quite move past that point of grief. So some people say you might skip to the next one. but there will be moments where you recall that pause in the process. So just remember this when you are writing, especially if it's a significant loss for your main character. Just remember that. So, and try to work that into your story. It'll make us as readers feel more immersed into the story, into the situation, and it will be a bonding moment for your character and your reader. Okay, so think about the loss, okay? So was this loss justified? Was this loss, you know, to what degree, I guess is a better word, to what degree did this loss affect your main character? Or what degree did it affect the plot or the storyline or the arc? Think about the promise of possibility that the character that has been lost or has died or was killed or murdered or whatever the case may be. Think about the promise of the possibility. So this can be where you show us that character, your main character's, you know, darkest hour. Maybe you could weave it into there. Maybe they can recall a conversation or a relevant piece of information, maybe that they had, you know, earlier in the story before the loss of this character for them. Maybe you can bring us back to that moment, and this could be that moment that brings them out of the depths of despair. Just different ways that you can use that grief and the process of grief to really bring us closer into the story, immerse us both in feeling for them and also for that relatability aspect, drawing that reader in closer. Okay, now also the manner in which this person died, or the, you know, their age. Was it old age? Was it a disease? Was it a curse? Was it, you know, an accident? Was it a murder? Was it a suicide? Was the deceased, what relationship did your main character have to the deceased? What were the intimacy levels there? Also, were they an infant, a toddler, a child, a teen, young adult, adult, mid-age, elder, whatever the case may be. Think about that connection and that intimacy level, because these things can also pull at your heartstrings on different levels. Not that death isn't painful, no matter the age, no matter the circumstance, but there are ways that you can tug on your reader's heartstrings and really use this process to show us a different side of your main character. You know, maybe they respond differently to the passing or the loss of a certain character because of the age in which they were lost. You know, maybe that character had tremendous potential, or maybe they were the future of this new realm. Did they hold any significance to that main character's life and them reaching their goals? You know, did they play a key part? So anyway, just consider this. If it was a, you know, an elder, maybe this was their, you know, mentor. So how might that affect their decision-making process moving forward without the, you know, the reliance on that mentor character? Just things to think about, guys. Moving on. Let's see, what I really wanted you to take away from this particular lesson, if you will, today, is just remember the intimacy. I'm going to have to change spaces here. The intimacy and the relationship between your main character and the person that is lost. Remember also, how does it affect their daily life? Are there any interruptions in that daily life or their journey moving forward? How might this be manifested? How might you connect with the reader on a more deeper, intimate level? How might you immerse the reader? So also think about how it might affect the character and their actions moving forward, including the plot. Also, could you give us an anchor moment? Could you give us an anchor moment where it is more relatable in that state of vulnerability? Also, help us to connect emotionally with the aspect, or with emotional aspects to the reader, so you can help immerse the reader deeper into your story and care. Also, the impact that you will leave with deciding to implement the process of grief, not just saying they died and they acknowledge their death and they move on. That's not really helping you connect with the reader. So all of us, this is a universal theme of death, because all of us have experienced it to some level in our lifetime. So bringing and playing upon that impactful moment, bringing that gut punch to life for your readers as well as your character can really give us that moment that we relate to, and that will really, you know, cause a reader to just sob and really have that connection. You know what I'm saying? Okay, moving on. So the impact or that gut punch moment, let us see it, you know, play it out fully. Let us see that, how it might affect their daily lives. It's not just a one and done. I've seen it done in books, and it irritates me to no end, because of the fact that a lot of the times the main character, you know, you are shown them with, you know, character A, whatever the case may be, however the relationship is, but we see them with this character, and then later in the story, that character is killed off, and it doesn't seem to affect the main character one way or the other. So I don't like that in books. I like to be drawn in, and every character has a place. You know, I like that kind of story, where every character makes a difference in the plot, where every character gives me the emotional feels, helps me feel more immersed. So, you know, a lot of times when this is done well, you will find yourself, especially if you're an emotional person or an emotional reader, you will find yourself in those gut-punching moments, sobbing right along with the main character. So that's what you want. You want to draw them in close enough where this reality has become your reader's reality, if that makes sense. Okay, so think about the triggers that they may have along the way. You know, maybe a certain symbol or a sign or a place or a song or even an activity can bring back that moment of just, you know, visceral, guttural sadness or sorrow. You know, let it play, because we don't just get over it, you know? So if you don't just get over it in life, then show us that moment, so that way your characters in your book come to life. Okay, so then think about the change in their action or their response to things, the triggers that might happen, or if it affects their decision-making process at one time or another while moving through the process or stages of grief. So that's all I have for you today. I do so help that, or hope that this helps you in some small way when you are writing those character death scenes, how it might affect your main character. So keep it real. You don't have to go into every single stage, but you can give your reader a hint of where they might be in the stages, or in that process of grief. It can help not only anchor your reader into that situation or into your world, where your main character lives, but it can also really play upon, you know, our sympathies and our relatabilities to your main character. It can help immerse the reader even deeper. So if this video helped you or provided you with some value, please hit that like button, subscribe if you want to, and ding that bell. It'll notify you the next time that I upload new content. Usually, guys, it's on Tuesdays and Thursdays at 10 a.m. Central Time. Thanks so much for joining me today. Sorry about the somberness. Remember, this is a disclaimer. It's only my opinion. And take it with a grain of salt. If it helped you and you could figure out a way to implement these things into your story, it can only, you know, up that level of, you know, not breaking the fourth wall. It keeps your reader involved in your world and intimately involved with your characters. So, anyway, I will see you guys in the next one, and happy writing. Bye, guys.